बी रेडी स्टार्ट सर देयर आर थ्री फैक्टर्स कनेक्टेड विद इंडस्ट्रियल रिलेशंस फर्स्टली सर द मैनेजमेंट एंड ऑफिसर्स शुड नो द नॉर्म्स ऑफ इंडस्ट्रियल रिलेशंस आई डू नॉट फाइंड एनी ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम फॉर ट्रेनिंग हाउ टू डील विद द स्टाफ और हाउ टू डील विद problems expeditiously. If they do not change their outlook, if they do not attend to the grievances in time, they will ultimately accumulate and create a grave crisis and we shall again be falling in some trap and strikes will become an annual feature or there will be strikes many times. Secondly, sir, there are large number of unions. Last time, a meeting was called of all the unions. There are craft-wise unions, station masters union, ticket collectors union, and so many others. And there is much scope for politicians and others to multiply unions because the occupations are 700 to 800. There are only two federations. The railway have not taken steps to eliminate multiplicity of unions. Unless this is done, there can be no concrete results. In order to make collective bargaining successful, I feel that the policy of industrial relations and industry-wise unions should extend to this. The scheduled caste and scheduled tribes want their separate union and the tribal people also want their separate union in the railways. I feel, sir, that they must be completely banned. There should be large industrial unions which can deliver the goods and which alone can create an atmosphere of good relations between the railways and their employees. Sir, the third thing I would like to suggest is that they must find out the bottlenecks. But there is no attempt. There is no wage policy. Today, the people belonging to scheduled caste and scheduled tribes are employed as contingent for casual labor in many places and they are paid the wages which the collector in each district fixes. This contingent labor consisting of 2 or 3 lakh people at different places is paid 50% less than what regular employees are paid or what the All India pay scale is. They have been working for years and are getting different wages in different districts depending upon the minimum wage or the collector fixing the pay scales and wages in that state. Discrimination is very great. I would like the minister to look into the matter. The contingent labor should be paid at par with other railway employees. Sir, another point which is very important is about the promises given by the railways at the time of strike. A large number of people, when the interests of the nation were in danger, staked their lives. They were on duty. Many were assaulted. At that time, a promise was given that their children or their dependents will get priority in employment. But instead of that, after the strike was over, many of them were assaulted. I would like to know from the Honorable Minister what happened to the promises given by him to the employees who were on duty, who staked their lives. How many people and how many of their dependents have been given jobs in the last 1 year? If the promises given to them at a crucial time are not fulfilled, the government will lose its credibility and the workers will not be able to do their duty properly and faithfully. I would like to say two other things for the sake of good and happy industrial relations. BOSIMS must go. In all the modern countries, industrial relations have become successful because the officers treat their employees on equal basis and informally. They help them to solve their problems. Therefore, the attitude of the officers in the railway administration will go a long way in improving the industrial relations in this vital sector of economy. I would also ask, why should the government or the railway administration feel shy in applying the Industrial Disputes Act to its employees? No reference has been made to it. Not a single question is referred for adjudication to the industrial tribunal or any machinery under the industrial law. Railways being the biggest transport industry, they should accept as a norm of industrial relations that their problems will also be referred to adjudication machinery available in our country. Small things like termination or suspension may not be very big or important from the railway administration point of view, but it is of vital importance to the individual employee who is suspended for months and years together and does not get any redress. He has to rely upon the mercy of the deciding authorities. It may take 1 or 2 years. In the state from which I come, under the Bombay Industrial Relations Act, if a man is terminated from service or dismissed, he can go to the labor court or his grievance can be looked into within 3 months. If it is found that he has been wrongly dismissed, he can be reinstated. This is a great deterrent for officers acting arbitrarily. I therefore suggest that norms must be laid down for industrial relations. Stop. Over.